Everyone, how are you guys doing? How's everybody doing in YouTube land this day, this evening, or this night, whatever time of the day it is that you are watching? So welcome. Hello, how are you guys doing? Are you guys ready for another cooking with common sense cooking here on YouTube? How you doing today, Ryan?
Good.
You ain't doing good. You ready to go see WWE? Just to let y'all know, WWE is on in the background. Shout out to The Miz. Shout out to Snoop. Shout out to everybody. Okay. So we're coming on today. We're going to be cooking today. You guys know we had one of my friends that wanted to invest in this channel with a cooking show because she wanted a cooking show, child. She was like, look. If I got to send y'all food to cook, I'm going to send y'all food to cook. So this is the Wild Alaskan Company, and today we're going to be cooking Pacific cod, okay, from Wild Alaskan Company. I have never cooked cod before, so don't hurt me if I do it wrong, okay? But we're going to cook her up, and we're going to be serving this cod with this type of salad that it's my go-to salad. It's a salad that I just made up, and you are going to love it, okay? Enough with all the fatty foods and the snacks and the delectables. Which way am I going, this way or that way? Which way am I going? Enough with all the crazy foods, okay? We're going to keep it real today. So while Brian rotates this stuff, making me scared. Okay. So welcome to everybody. We wanted to talk about, what are you attracting, child? Are you attracting good vibes or bad vibes in friendships? Okay. That's what we're talking about today while we're cooking. And this is going to be a short, simple meal. It's not that much brain power that goes into it. Okay. So we're going to be talking about, what are you attracting in friendships? And I want to first say to everybody, thank you so much for the condolences for my family member. I truly appreciate it. It's still in our minds. Like, we can't believe this has happened. So it's a lot. And it's just very unfortunate because right now I can't go home for the services. So I've just been alerting my siblings, talking to my parents about it and things like that. So that's the unfortunate thing about living far in another state. You just don't have the means to just pick up and go somewhere, you know, to situations like this. So it's just rather unfortunate. So let's get into it. The reason why I brought up this topic today is because my pastor was preaching this morning, and he was preaching on, you know, what you attract. And this was the analogy that he used. The analogy he used was the moon. Okay. And just to let you guys know, I got this bowl. I think this bowl is so nice. Okay. I got this bowl from IKEA. I want to say this bowl was like 20 bucks. And they have the smaller ones. Let me show you. They have the smaller ones to put your salad in. And I don't know, it's just something about this bowl makes me want to eat salad. It's just something about this bamboo bowl, child. It makes me want to eat a salad, girl. It's just something about when you get a fork and you just hear that sound while your salad's moving. It just sounds
wonderful. It makes that sound in any kind of bowl, doesn't it?
No, it makes the sound like at the restaurant, honey. Y'all remember how the Kardashians used to eat their salads out of white containers, the clear containers? They would be on there eating out of them clear containers. Make you want a salad. This bowl makes me want a salad. Okay?
So or, a really big bowl of cereal. That works too.
You eat cereal out of that bowl. You're not telling me?
There are people who eat cereal out of this.
You've been eating cereal out of that?
No, I have not, but I'm just saying.
The other bowl I want to show y'all, and this is not sponsored, by the way. These bowls right here are the truth. So these are Tupperware bowls. You could get these at Target. And basically what I like to do is store my salad, like, you know, the actual salad from the store out the bags. I store them in these. And for those of you that don't know, you push the button in the middle, child, and that snaps it down.
Really?
Yeah, you push the little button in the middle and it snaps it down.
I didn't know that.
And if it doesn't close all the way, like if it won't fit all the way on, then you heat it up in some hot water. You just put it in some lightly hot water and then you close it and it'll close.
Look at you.
Trying to learn you something.
I do a TikTok. I was today years old.
Trying to learn you something, honey. Trying to learn you something.
That the little okay? button is what closes it.
So the reason why we're talking about this today is because my pastor had mentioned this morning in his sermon that if you notice, the moon is completely, is void of any light, right? Unless light is shining on the moon, you're not going to see it. Here's the reason why when we have a new moon, we don't see the moon, okay? For at least a week or so. So he was saying that the reason why we see the moon at night and we see the moon sometimes even during the day is because of the light that's reflecting off of the sun. And he was saying sometimes you got to look at your friendships and your friend circle and even sometimes your family. What is reflecting off of that, okay? What is reflecting off of you? If that person who is the sun is reflecting light, okay, it's going to reflect off of you, okay? If they're shining light on you, it's going to reflect off of you. People will see you. If they ain't giving you nothing, honey, it's going to be darkness, okay? And a lot of times in family, where did I put my vegetable wash? This is my little vegetable wash. Y'all know I like from Trader Joe's, okay? I wash my vegetables. A lot of times in friendships, we find ourselves, like I always call them closet freaks. That's my term for it. People keep you like a closet freak. They don't let people know y'all friends. Y'all can't tell. I used to have a friend at MD Anderson. She used to be like not wanting everybody at work to know that we were friends because she was friends with a boss that didn't like me. So she didn't want that lady to know that she was friends with me. So everything we would do couldn't be posted on social media. I couldn't talk to her at work and let people know that we was cool outside of work. And nobody got time for that. Okay? I'm too grown for them type of nonsense, this type of nonsense at this age. Okay? Now, the other thing is, too, it works that way in family also. Okay? Even with family, it works like that. Let me turn the camera so y'all can see. Even in family, it works that way, okay? With people sitting up here, you know, attracting negative. It's like with the situation with Latasha and, what's the sister's name? Tamika. Tamika followed everything Latasha said to do back in the past, okay? And whatever negativity she was putting out for Tamika, I mean for Latasha, she did it, right? Because whatever vibes Latasha was putting off for Tamika, Tamika ran with it, okay? Negativity begets negativity, okay? And then now that she woke up out of the darkness and she's around people with light like Candy and the other Tamika, Tiny, now all of a sudden now she's had this newfound, you know, aha moment or revelation about her sister, okay? So for me, it's all about what you attract. If you attract positivity, you get positivity. You attract negativity, you get negativity, okay? So that's just my thought process on the whole entire situation. Also, if you give out reciprocity, if you give out to people, you will reap positive reciprocity from people, meaning people will give to you. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of times, some of us don't know how to receive that. Okay? And I'm just like drying the fish off, y'all. I'm just soaking up the water with a paper towel. Okay, I already cleaned my fish. I ain't one of those people take it out the pack and like, don't clean it, girl. I clean my fish. Okay? So, I hope y'all could see. Y'all could see. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start by adding my seasonings to this. I got a little bit of lemon juice, but I'm not going to pour the lemon juice all on there. I'm just going to like kind of give me the brush out of here. I'm going to lightly coat it with lemon juice first. I don't want to douse it with lemon juice because I just took all the water out of it. So I don't want to like douse it with lemon juice. Like just pour it on there, girl. We don't want no soggy fish, girl. Okay. And I got my oven already heated to 400. And once I'm done seasoning, I'm going to put it in the oven for 20 minutes. Okay. I'm going to leave a little bit of that for at the end. Okay. So next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get this Lawry's garlic powder. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix everything in a little bowl. Y'all see I got my little bowl right here? Brian laughing. I'm going to add some garlic powder.
She really does love those bowls.
I love these bowls.
We can't touch them unless she's around. We can't eat out of them.
Tell them again.
Can't do nothing with them bowls.
That's right.
I think she cares about those moles more than she cares about me.
Don't say that.
Okay. On Tuesdays.
Now you going too far. Only on Sundays I care about them more than you. Okay. Can you look over there for that seasoning? The one that says that blackening seasoning?
I think I put it up.
You put it up?
It's not this bowl.
Show me. Where you put it?
Let me see.
It ain't in there.
Hold on.
Okay, I'm going to add a little paprika. I'm going to add some onion powder. Some black pepper. I thought it was behind that stuff over there by the bag, but I guess not. You stash it all the way up in there. I'm going to use a little bit of this blackening seasoning. I just found this in the store, Cajun's Choice. And it's from, because I like to shout out my people from back. It's from Broussard, Louisiana, child. Shout out to Broussard. Okay? What's up to all my Broussard people? Y'all know I'm from Lafayette. All right? Got to give my people back home a little shout out from Broussard, Louisiana. Cajun's Choice blackening seasoning. We're going to add a little bit of that. Okay. And then y'all know I can't do anything without a little bit of Slap Your Mama. This is from Ville Platte, Louisiana. Shout out to Ville Platte. My mama live in Opelousas, girl. Okay. Then we're going to add some lemon pepper. And y'all, a lot of these spices I get from the dollar store. From Dollar Tree. I'm going to just keep it real with y'all. Dollar Tree, we have these spices and seasonings tried for a dollar. Okay? My cameraman is adjusting the camera. So I'm going to add a little bit of lemon pepper. In the words of Miss Tabitha Brown, like this, like that. Okay? Not a little bit of a lot of lemon pepper. Then I'm going to add some parsley flakes. Okay, girl. Just broke that off. All right. Like that. And I'm going to add a little bit of Old Bay seasoning. And I know for y'all, y'all probably like, girl, what is you doing with all that seasoning? Just pay attention, girl. Okay? Just understand the process. This is what we do in Louisiana. We just add, okay? And then I'm just going to mix this and blend this all together. Let me see. I need a spark. So I'm just going to mix this up. Like this. Yeah, there you go. Y'all see that? Let me mix that up like that. Okay. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to sprinkle this on top. And with the Pacific cod, just to explain to you guys, one piece came in one pack, another piece came in another pack. These two pieces right here were together. This piece just broke off. Okay. So just FYI. So I'm just going to drizzle that on top. And this is the bottom pieces right here. So what I'm going to do, so I'm going to take my olive oil right here in this container. And I'm just going to drizzle with some olive oil. Okay. And I'm just going to massage that in like that. Because this is the back piece. So now I'm going to flip it over. What'd you say, Brian?
Say massage it in.
Massage it in, honey. Okay. And we're going to go in again on this side. Because I like my stuff seasoned. I don't know about y'all, but I like my stuff seasoned, child. I don't like no bland nothing.
What you were saying about friends and reflecting and stuff rubbing off. So, in your opinion, when it comes to friendships and friends, why do people say birds of a feather flock together then?
In my opinion, It could be a good thing and a bad thing.
Okay.
I feel people associate that with bad things all the time. I'm just adding a little bit more paprika. I feel people associate that with bad things all the time, but it could be good things too. Birds of a feather do flock together. I don't see crows mixing with pigeons.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I don't see eagles messing around with hawks. I'm just saying. Do you?
No.
So birds of a feather flock together, honey. That's the way I look at it.
So when you're a positive person, right, and say you're saying you have all these friends and you said it's supposed to reflect off of them onto the person. So what if you meet a person who they're supposed to be your friend, but you try to be positive, but they're just always negative about everything?
Then you got to kick them to the end of the street.
Immediately, or do you work on
it? Yeah, no. At 40 years old, you kick them to the curb. Okay, you don't have time to play these games. Okay, that's just the way I look at it. You kick them to the curb. Ain't nobody got time to be playing these damn games with people at this day and age, at this big age. They always want to say, "Oh, at your big age, at your big age." Well, how about at my little age, big age, old age? Put me in the grave age. I don't care. I ain't got time. Okay, now y'all know I love this pen. This is an all clad pen, okay? And I saw it and I said, this would be perfect to put my fish inside. So it's on 400. I'm just gonna slide that on in. And we're gonna let that cook for 20 minutes because I like my stuff cooked, child. I don't like no undercooked damn food meat, okay? I might need to put it in there for 22 minutes. How about that? Okay. So, put that in there. And next, we're going to get started on this. All right. Now, what was you saying you was talking about? What did you say?
About what?
About people.
You already answered it. You said birds of a feather.
No, but you said something after that, Brian.
And I said, so if a person's always negative, how do you deal with them? And you said you'll just kick them to the curb.
No, you kick them to the curb immediately. Like, but I just don't have the time. I don't. Like, okay, so let me explain this. Maybe I don't kick them to the curb. Maybe we just mutually just be acquaintances and not BFFs. But there's some people that I just get tired. Like, if you're not reflecting positivity onto me in my life, then why am I constantly upping you and helping you get to the next level in your life? Like, it gets exhausting at some point. Don't you think?
Well, as you said on the last video, I don't have that many friends.
You don't have no friends.
I do have friends.
Just me and Madison.
No, I have friends. But I think for me, I don't put...
Who is these friends?
I don't put expectations on people. That's the thing. And I think when you don't put expectations on things or on relationships or friends, then you never get your heart broken. Because I don't ever expect anything from anybody. If somebody does something, I'm shocked.
You don't expect nothing from me?
We're not talking about you. You were addressing the issue that everybody said we were cooking. But for me, I just don't put expectations out there. Exactly. Because when you do that, you're just setting yourself up for a heartbreak or for some sort of disappointment or some kind of something that people do. So I just don't put much stock in it. I just take it one day at a time and let a person show me their hand. And once they show me their hand, then I got to know that that's who they really are.
Well, tell me about your negative experiences with people and with friendships.
I mean, it happens often. I mean, there's been times I'm sure people who are watching might have a friend or a family member or somebody who might have even said, hey, you know what? I need you to help me get a job, or I need you to help make a recommendation for something. And then you put your name or your neck on the line for this person, thinking that they're going to do what they got to do, and then they let you down. Then you find out that your brand and your reputation now is at risk because you put yourself out there trying to help somebody, and they wasn't even as much or as courteous enough to say, let me put my best foot forward, because I'm not only representing myself, but I'm representing the person that put my foot in the door. So it's like, oftentimes that's happened to me in the past on the professional side, but even on the friendship side, just having friends, you know, people see you, they see you in a fraternity, your frat brothers, the people may come up to you and say, hey, B, I'm in between checks. Can you let me hold something? And I'm like, okay, I got you. I'm gonna look out for you. And then, this was before marriage. This was back in the day. But then you realize that the person doesn't have your best interest at heart, and they're not even trying to give you back what you gave them. And you find yourself giving, and they just taking. So that energy is not the same. Or you might find yourself trying to, you know, be in a situation where, okay, you know what, I want to clean up my credit. I want to do better. I want to get better. And then that person is still trying to distract you and have you going back to saying all the same old things you did.
Going to the Louis Vuitton store.
Making all the bad decisions that you used to make and keeping yourself broke. So, I mean, you want to have people at least that you associate yourself with that's trying to do better, that's trying to go in the same direction that you're trying to go, so you can motivate each other, rather than having somebody sitting there praying for your demise or hoping what you do doesn't succeed, because that's an excuse for them to keep you where you are and keep themselves in a certain place. So it happens.
So let me give everybody an example. So I had a friend that just last week, it was her birthday. I didn't even know. She didn't even tell me. This is a new friend, by the way. So don't come try to check me. You should know your friend's birthday. This is a new friend. She didn't even tell me. Okay? Her birthday is 2-3 days before mine. She didn't tell me jack. So she goes out of town. And while she's out of town, it's during my birthday. So she messages me and she says, hey, I'm over here in Europe. I want to know if you need any makeup. First couple of times she asked me, I told her, don't worry about it. Then I thought about it. You know what? Let me check into some things. So that's when I saw Mac had the new makeup over in Europe, but they didn't have it here in the U.S. just yet. So I told her, hey, can you pick this up for me from the Mac store and also a couple other like skincare products? Because I don't know if y'all know, the skincare in Europe is 10 times better than what we have in the U.S. So I was like, okay, girl, can you pick these things up for me? Now, mind you, she never talked about price, but I knew when she would get back, I would tell her, like, what is my total? So then I got a message from her. She got back yesterday. She was like, oh, just letting you know, I already put the stuff in the mail. FYI. I'm like, okay, what's the total? She said, no, that's your birthday gift. I said, oh, thank you so much. Because I'm learning to receive when people do stuff for me. Because one thing's for sure, you could self-sabotage yourself when people say, oh, girl, you know, this is for you. And you're just like, no, 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 I want to pay you. 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 People get accustomed to that. You know what? April ain't going to April is going to give me my money back. So I'll just buy whatever April want, and she's going to give me my money back. The one time you be like, oh, girl, okay, thank you, they're going to be looking at you weird because they're used to you just saying, don't worry about it. So I've learned now I worry about it, okay? I'm going to ask. So I asked her, and then she was like, no, so I received it, okay? It's a blessing. Then I turn to her, and I'm like, hey, when is your birthday? She tells me March 20th. I about threw that phone on the floor. I said, you mean to tell me you didn't tell me it was your birthday? She said, no, I thought I told you. I said, you know you didn't tell me. But that's just the type of person she is. She's very selfless, extremely selfless. And I told her, I said, well, you're going to have some stuff showing up to your house. A lot of people be like, oh, well, you shouldn't have to do that for your friends. Your friends is dead. Okay, girl. But you could still be a good person and a kind person. And some people love language as gifts. Some people's love language is given to others. So you have to know what that person's love language is. And to me, you, in my opinion, you should surround yourself with people with the same love language as yours. Because then you won't feel like you're being taken advantage of. You won't feel like, you know, like some people feel like they love language is just giving you attention, just giving you positive affirmation. Well, girl, I don't need that. My love language is gifts, okay? And there's nothing wrong in saying what your love language is. That's how people communicate with you and get things done. And you feel validated and you feel wanted, in my opinion. So I told her that. And then we had another conversation about along the lines of what we're talking about. So basically, I put in this bowl butter lettuce, and then I took the broccoli florets and the cauliflower florets, and I cut the stems off. I do not like the stems in my salads, okay? So I cut just the tops off, and I kind of broke them up a little bit, put them in the salad. And then next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut some carrots. Usually, I just buy shredded carrots, but they didn't have none at Target. So I'm going to roll with these little carrots, and we're going to cut these up. Okay? So then we were talking this morning, and I was telling her, you know, like, I'm very fortunate to have her in my life because one of the attendees at the conference was telling us about this secret thing that's going on behind the scenes. And at one point last week, I was like, you know what? Maybe I should go back to work. Maybe I should go work with my coworkers at this new place they're working at and just go back to work, girl, because YouTube messed me up by demonetizing me. So I was like, maybe I should just go back to work, rebuild my ends back up, and then try it again later. And then I went to the summit, and somebody dropped some knowledge on us, and I was like, no, I'm going to go learn a whole new career. I'm going to learn this new stuff that just came out that's going to help me prepare myself for where America is going in the next 15 years. And I'm going to be ready. I refuse to not be ready for this. While everybody else is sleeping, I'm trying to get to my bag, as always. So I told her about what the subscriber said at the summit, and she knows two people very, very close to her that are doing these jobs. And she was like, I could hook you up. She didn't just say it just to be saying it. She already done contacted these people. Okay? She already done contacted these people. She already in talks with these people. She done already told me what books to go and get, what I need to study, what I need to do. That's what I'm talking about. A lot of times y'all be hearing some of y'all friends be having these high profile jobs. And maybe your spouse, maybe you yourself, might could benefit from having one of these high-profile jobs in the government, right? And then you'd be like, oh, okay, well, my husband is looking. You'll just say it in passing. Oh, my husband is looking for a job doing that. If they do not offer, say, oh, girl, you know, Let me hook you up because we need more people like you, or we need more people like your husband in this field. If they don't say that, you know what that tells me? They tell me they lying. Okay? They ain't doing the ish that they say that they're doing. Regardless if it's a job in government or a job in corporate America that they so say making six figures and making all this money and doing all these things. If you got friends that can't offer to put their neck on the line for you or your husband, they don't trust you enough, like Brian was just saying, they don't trust you enough to like hook you up, or they see you as competition, get rid of them people. Because it's one of two things. They either sitting up there lying about that damn job, okay? They lying about that damn job. Number two, and when I say lying about the job, meaning they ain't really doing what they doing, or they ain't at the level that they saying that they at. Number two, they don't trust you. They don't trust you. They don't trust your husband to come up in there and do the job and do it well, okay? And number three, what was the third thing I just said? Competition. They see you as potential to come in and compete with them and make them look bad, so they wouldn't even hook you up. So them type of people, cut them out. Cut them out, cut them off, get them out your life, move on. Because after what I seen in this friendship that I have, this is a true friend, okay? This is somebody that ain't never met Brian a day in their life and ready to put their neck on the line for Brian to help Brian get better and do better. You need some people like that in your life. And if you don't have them type of people in your life, it's okay to be alone and be by yourself too. That's another issue. People too afraid to be alone. People too afraid. We see too many people on Instagram doing their birthday parties, going on their trips, living their best life. Y'all have to understand, that's work for them. That ain't real life. That's work. Okay? That's not real life, girl. That's work. They work buddies. They work friends, girl. That's not real life. Girl, I'm just saying. What you guys to say, Brian? And let me show y'all real quick what the salad looks like. So this is what it looks like. This is what she looked like, okay? And then on top of the salad, this is what we put. We put these wonton strips, okay? We put the wonton strips, and this is basically like a little Asian salad. That's why I like the shredded carrots more than the ones I just chopped up. And then I top it with this Asian sesame dressing by Ken Steakhouse. This stuff is the bomb. I got all my coworkers on this, girl. Okay. So I don't put the wontons and I don't put the dressing until it's plated. Okay. And you seen that?
Mm-hmm.
You see that?
I saw it.
Oh, girl. That looks good. I'm going to let that finish cook 5 more minutes and then I'm going to put it on broil. Okay. What you guys to say about everything, Brian, I just said?
I mean, pretty much said everything. I mean, that's kind of what you look for in an ideal situation. But I guess for me, I'm just more concerned about the people who say, well, hey, I met a person. They're not like that. What do they do after that? And I know for you, maybe easy just to say cut them off. But then you have those who say that and they just can't seem to do it, or they keep on finding people that are the same way and they end up going through the same thing again. So I think more of this conversation should not be what to do, more of how to do it. And I think the best way to do it is to have a heart-to-heart conversation with that person and truly find out and truly find out if that person is worth it. I mean, if it's even worth the conversation, because you may not realize something about that person. That person may be needing more help than they let on.
Then you ain't got time to help. At 45, I don't have time to help.
We're not speaking just for you. We're speaking for everybody that's watching that may be in a situation that may need some help. and they may need some guidance and may not know. The young lady that's on there, she just told you she was a college student. She's not 45, so her thought process is not there just yet.
College student age. Get them all. This is what I had to learn. This is from college. When I was in college and I was going to x-ray school, I was the oldest one. The oldest, not in my x-ray class, but in my dorm. So when I went to x-ray school, my school didn't offer dormitories, so I had to stay on Southern's campus in Southern's apartments. Those apartments right there outside of Southern University before you go over the bridge, I used to stay in them apartments right there, okay? And one of the issues was in my apartment, it was 4 bedrooms, 4 bathrooms. Everybody had their bathroom inside their room. And out of all my roommates, I was the oldest. I was 23, 24. They were like 18, 19 years old. So they used to call me mama. When I tell you I hated it, I hated it because these girls were always coming to me, asking me questions, helping me with, asking for help with their life issues and problems. That's why you hear me call myself mother now. Because I'm mama to one person. She in that room back there. Well, two, one person and a half, a little dog too. Okay? That's all I got. All right? I've been trying to ask Mr. Bryant to let me have another child. Mr. Bryant told me no. Mr. Bryant said, get on with that bull crap because you are not about to blame me for shooting your club up. Okay?
What? What are you talking about?
It's young people lingo, child. I'm talking to the young people. Okay? So at the end of the day, I wish I knew what I know now. Which is, ain't nobody got time. Look, it's 2023. Okay? In 15 more years, America is going to change like you ain't never seen before. This world is going to change like you ain't never seen before. We ain't got time for that. If they ain't bringing to the table, which you see this right here, this friendship I'm talking about, it's two people actually. These friendships I'm talking about, okay, it gives within the first like week of friendship. If within the first month, you think about it, apply your friendships like y'all apply them relationships with the men. If a man ain't opening up your door, if a man ain't buying your meals, if a man ain't doing all the things you got on that long list of things for men, you need to start setting up boundaries and start setting up requirements for friends. If they ain't checking them boxes, girl, they got to go. And that's a fact, Jack. Okay? They got to go. You have to treat your friendship like you treat a relationship with a man, like you treat a relationship with a woman. If they ain't giving, y'all be skedaddling and moving on, okay? Start treating those friendships like that. That's my opinion. You ask me for my opinion, that's what it is. Don't be asking that one too much. He ain't got that many friends.
And what, you got like a laundry list of friends?
I got a bunch.
You ain't got a bunch. Stop with the lies.
I got enough. I got two good ones.
Okay, that's all it should okay? be. It's about two or three good ones. But as far as the rest
two
of them.
Two good ones. I ain't seen one yet.
That's a lie. They live in Texas. They on their way out here next month.
Oh, really? You ain't told me that?
Sure didn't. It's a guy's time.
So when are you going to tell me?
When you told me you was going your Galentine's, the night of.
Natasha, you see the shade?
I didn't say her name. You just put her out there. So now the cat is out the bag.
Natasha, you see the shade?
No.
You see the shade, Tosh?
No shade. You just said I didn't have no friends. My friends are coming from Texas. They getting on a plane and they coming. Yours is already here. I'm just saying. Who put in more work? The ones coming.
I got friends in North Carolina, and I got friends in D.C. too.
Isn't there a song called I Got Friends in Low Places? Uh-huh. To the Oasis. I got you.
Oasis. Uh-uh. Stop. I got friends in low places.
Don't laugh, you guys. Something's wrong with her. It's not funny.
No, in all seriousness, though, I wish I would have known this when I was younger, like when I was in college, because I would not have put up with the bull crap that I did. I wish I would have known this like a couple years ago, like in my 30s, because I would not have put up with bull crap that I did. That's on God. That's on sight. My mama called me today with some bull crap going on back home. I just laugh. Even with my own family, I just laugh because I'm not in it. If y'all want to ostracize me and boot me out the family when y'all feel like it because I don't take y'all bull crap and I have boundaries, then when y'all going through ish, that's not my problem. Get somebody else to do it.
Tasha just said I'm an oak tree of shade.
Get somebody else to do it. Because it ain't going to be me. I don't know why my mama be calling me with that bull crap anyway. And let me show y'all what this look like. What it do?
Oh, look who made it. Gina.
Look, Gina.
She was still watching the broadcast from the summit. She thought we had went to lunch.
So let me show you guys.
Gina said, why she thought it was I Got Hoes in Different Area Codes. Wrong song, Gina.
Wrong song, girl.
Wrong song.
Wrong one. All right. So let me show y'all. Let me plate this for y'all. Let me plate this for y'all.
Somebody said, no, the butchers are not tallying up friends. It's not even Italian, guys. I could count
mine. I just be messing with him.
I could count on one hand, but it takes a lot for me.
I just be messing with him.
It takes a lot to move from that associate stage to the friendship stage for me. And you got to put in something for me to give you that. You got to have some skin in the game.
He don't play.
For me to call you my friend. I'll have a conversation with you. You can bounce ideas off me. I might even make you laugh two or three times. But it's not going to be
He'll make you think that he your friend.
It's not going to be no friendship because at the end of the day, sometimes you got to hold people in a different, you know, space and place. And I got to keep you there until I can feel comfortable in letting my guard down to let you come in. Because once you're in there, you're in there. I cut hard for my friends. That's just the Leo in me. So if you get to that point, anybody who out there that's a Leo knows we're very protective over what's ours. And we don't play around with it. We might let you do us any kind of way, but you're not going to do those ones that we consider close to us any kind of way.
Cold snap.
So
he didn't serve y'all papers.
Okay. No, I'm just saying. That's just the real thing about being a Leo.
That's another thing, too. It's like knowing people's signs. Some signs just don't. I got to feel you out. Maybe I might let you be an associate, but you could never be a true friend of mine. That too. That part too. Okay? So, this is my dressing, girl. Okay? I took the wontons. I put them on top. They can see?
Yeah. It's kind of not in focus.
And I'm going to drizzle this with some dressing.
You're making that for me?
For you.
Then you need more dressing, sister. You know, I like to have dressing with my salad, not salad with dressing.
All right.
Oh, man.
And then, where's that spatula? Oh, it was up here. Where did you go?
The flat bed.
Oh, I got it.
Okay.
Him.
Oh, here go Gina. And like the old saying says, Brian is nobody's friend. Gina, I am people's friend. But the problem is that you gotta be able to show reason why I need to be your friend. Yeah, it's gotta be a reason why. I don't just give that away all willy-nilly. April used to in the past, and now she doesn't either.
Nope.
And she's a lot better for it.
Say that again.
I'm just telling you, man. You find yourself putting a whole lot of energy into people who's not worth that energy. You can't get that back. Once it's gone, it's gone.
Y'all see this? Oh, yeah. Look at that. Mm-hmm. Here you go, Mr. Brian.
All right.
Tell me what you think.
Let's see.
Okay.
It's very good.
No, I'm gonna say it like Madison. Oh, it's just good. It's not best.
So Madison has this scale of how she rates things. Of course, a thumbs up is great. Sideways is and of course down. I give it a thumbs up. It's really good, actually.
The seasoning. Does it taste like bear snout?
No, not this time. that's IKEA meatballs. But really good taste. Only thing that would have made the cotta any different is probably putting a little butter, but the oil with the seasoning.
Well, get you some butter.
No, it's good.
It's your house. This ain't no cooking show where
where you gotta get it the way it is and eat it that way.
Exactly. This ain't Top Chef. No, okay.
You're not Gordon Ramsay?
No, I ain't. Well, you know what? I'm Gordina Ramsfuchsia.
Okay.
How you doing?
See, I don't like eating on here because the last time somebody said that I was killing the plate, and they embarrassed me.
So, they embarrassed you?
Yeah, the person said I was eating like that was my last supper or something.
They wish they could eat this good. Let me see what they cooking inside the doggone...
Somebody's
inside their house.
They throwing down too. But this is a really good recipe. It's light.
I'm gonna burn my hand.
We're trying to get on this health kick, you guys. So it's time out on all the fast food and stuff. So this is something light, something simple, something that after you eat it, you're not gonna be screaming for a pillow. You could actually still get on with the rest of your evening.
I've never had cod unless it came from Wendy's.
And another thing we've been trying to do is we've been trying to eat before 6 o'clock. Definitely before 7. So right now it's 6:02 here. I know it's 2 hours in Central, 3 hours on the East Coast.
Mm.
But getting the meal in before that time gives your body plenty enough time to digest so that when you go to bed, you can actually sleep. Because if you're eating right before bed, your body's trying to digest that while you're sleeping, which can give you acid reflux, all kinds of other stuff. So we've been really trying to take this journey and eating healthier and doing better, and energy levels have gone up. We've been feeling a lot better. So definitely one of those recipes to try.
Let me put y'all up on something. Y'all see this right here? Y'all see this?
That's a hidden gem.
This right here is better than A1 steak sauce.
And 57.
Y'all go to Texas Roadhouse and buy this.
A lot of
y'all better not sell this out.
They didn't even know that they sold it. That's something special. Mm. Texas Roadhouse does sell their steak sauce.
You want some of this on the side with their fish? I'm telling you.
Their steak sauce. Their steak sauce is like a hybrid of A1 and Heinz 57 sauce. If they like went
smoke
together.
Sauce. Yeah. It's like liquid smoke with A1 steak sauce.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Like if the two had a baby and they made that little sauce.
You
right
know
there.
What? Next time that's I do cod, I'm going to marinate it in this stuff.
Don't do that.
You don't think so?
It's going to hurt. Yeah, it's going to be very good. I'm saying don't do that.
Oh, yeah, I am going to do it.
Now, that's going to be a whole nother recipe.
I am going to do it.
Because that would be very good.
I'm going to marinate this joker next time. Because this stuff is slapping hard.
All right. Woo. Texas steak sauce. Okay. Texas Roadhouse steak sauce. Yes.
Texas Roadhouse steak
sauce.
Yes,
Tiff. It's off the chain.
Oh my God. Cause a cod tastes like steak. That's why I thought about it. Taste it.
I'm going to. I want to eat it. No, like, I'm not on camera, so I can really. What they don't want to see. No cod in my hair. Yeah. We know what that tastes like.
Brian, it ain't slapping.
It is good, but.
See, you can never be the Michaela. You can never be Michaela. You're not a hype man, man.
Which one they say?
Guys, this literally changed my life. I mean, wow.
You're crazy. Somebody said, April, your skin.
$10,000 skin. Y'all stop gassing me up.
Exactly.
Girl, I just did a detox, girl. That's what my skin is
popping. That's a whole nother video, guys. And I got the inside scoop on it. That's a whole nother video, that detox. It's a whole nother video.
Let me tell you something. That sauce slaps with this cod. Ooh, this sauce slaps, baby.
See, everybody's saying y'all enjoy y'all meal. Yes, I'm going to enjoy my meal.
Yeah, he about to get back to WWE, child.
Because WrestleMania, the second night is on. I got my Roman Reigns shirt on here. Well, actually, it's The Rock. It's the.
Whoa!
I just know that it's going to be a great night watching the rest of this.
They beat the brakes off of Logan Paul last night.
Yeah, Logan Paul got served last night. And I don't know if you guys watch wrestling, but Rey Mysterio, he's like an old school wrestler. He beat his son real bad.
That's all I know of the song.
Guys, you will never have to eat meat again.
That's what I know. That's what my mama be saying. That's what I know.
All right, so I'm signing off. Thank you guys for watching. I'm going to eat this. Watch the second half of WrestleMania. We love you guys.
Stay tuned for next week for Easter. We're going to be cooking it up for Easter, honey. We're going to have yams, dirty rice, ham.
I'm not eating no ham.
Turkey.
That's what I'll be eating.
Apple cobbler. Get ready.
And Brian, surprise.
What is Brian's surprise?
Not a damn thing. I'm just going to be surprised.
Bye, y'all.
Bye.